Hey guys, welcome back to Bait and Tackle, and today we're going to do continuation on spinnerbaits. We did a series on making them, pouring the lead. We did a series, or not a series, we did a video on pouring the lead. We did a video on paint dipping these into the taller white pearl fluid bed. And now these have already been painted. I'm ready to go. I got these clear coated as well. Now I'm going to show you how to put the wire bend on and what you need to do to build these out. So let's do it. So real quick, this isn't going to be a super long video. It's just going to be a quick video. So we're going to build one of these. First, we take a clevis, which is one of these little curled up pieces. I don't know if you've ever seen these before, but it's called a clevis. It's a little tiny half moon shape with two little holes in it. We're going to take one of the blades, the smaller one that I've got, and this is a size 3 mag willow blade, I believe is what they're called. I'm going to put a link to all the products down below for Barlow's. Then you slip it on to the wire, just like that. And you want it so that the indentation is on the bottom and the part that's bubbled out is on the top. So when the water flows through it, it kind of flakes it up this way, okay? So we're gonna put that on first. Then we're gonna take some beads. These are also from Barlow's. That's the part number right there. And I can't remember the clevis size. I wanna say it's a size 2 or 3, probably a 3. But we're gonna put 2 beads on. Then we're going to also put a spacer. So the beads are, I think, a medium size bead. This is a spacer. We're going to put 2 beads, then a spacer. Then we're going to do 2 more beads. Okay. And before we go any further, let me show you that's the spacer part number right there. Okay. That's all in Barlow's. Like I said, I'll link everything in the description below. Okay. So we need 1 more bead, if I can grab one without dropping them all. Put 1 more bead on here. So we have the clevis with a blade. We have 2 beads, a spacer, and 2 beads. Now we're going to take it over to the wire bender. And this is a little bit interesting. So the bottom part of the wire bender, this is a commercial wire bender. And I don't know if you guys are going to be able to see this real well. It's kind of tough to show on camera. Let's see if I can get you down just a little bit lower. There we go. So what this is going to do is going to put a wire bend into the spinner. And this is a little bit smaller wire than what I'm used to. So I'm just going to go ahead and bend it. We're just going to. And then you bring it all the way back so that you basically put a little kind of U in it. See that? Okay, then we throw it over on the other side like this and just bend it back just a hair. So let me just set you down real quick. We just bend it back just a little bit to get a little bit of a, almost like a little U there. So hopefully you guys can see this. Okay, there it is right there. So that's what we want. Okay, then you bring it up to the top part, which I'm not going to bring you very far here. And this little thing, this is a commercial wire bender. This, what you do, it's got this handle with a hook and the actual little eye here, you put on top of that peg then you put the wire into this and you put the straight piece from the spinner that way and you put the other piece out the other side. So when you close this, I don't know if you guys can see this very well. Let me try to get you a little better angle. So when you close that, it's going to put it right on top of that, and then you're going to twist it, and it's going to twist right on top of that thing. So let's just try this. And what you got to do is when you're turning this, you have to maintain pressure, okay? And you have to just keep turning, but you also have to give it enough room so that the wire wraps around. You do want the wire to wrap around, and I'm already kind of screwing it up. Okay, so two things. I think I had too much in there, so I took one bead out on the top of the spacer and the bottom. This time I'm going to turn it the other way. And like I said, be very mindful of the hook. That did a much better job. Okay. So I think I was going the wrong direction. That's what we're looking for right there. It may be a little off, twisted off offset, but the other one didn't come out as good as that. But again, these are spinners for me anyway. So, but I just wanted to show you how we do that. Let me bring you back over here and show you why there was a problem. So if you look here, there's too much going on here. There's too many things. This is going to flap like right here. So it's probably going to be in the way. So I'm just going to leave it though. I'm not going to mess with it because I'll probably end up breaking the wire. So you have to be very careful when you're doing the wire turning. And I probably should have, I'm trying to break this little, clip this little piece of wire off just so then, that way, I've got a little extra room. God dang it. There we go. Okay. So, this is the one that I did that I messed up on. But I can kind of redeem it. It's still wrapped around. We still should be okay. It's a little bit bent. Try to fix what we got here. But she's still going to ride okay. There we go. Just a lightweight spinner. It's like a quarter ounce. So no big deal. But the problem is you've got too much going on here. So I've got too much stuff in the way here. Okay. So that was probably a boo-boo on my part. So don't do two beads. Do it like this. That way you've got more room to do the wire tie. And then see how my blade's out here now. Then the second one will ride off with this little bearing swivel. It'll come off the top. I'll show you. This little barrel swivel. I get these on Amazon. I don't get these off of Barlow's. But you can, I'm sure I can find something that's very comparable to that, and I'll put it on there for you. It's a very small one. Then we'll put this on the back. So let's go ahead and add that to it. And I'll just go ahead and add them to both, even though the one's messed up. We're good with do that. We like to make mistakes on here. It's how we learn. We learn from mistakes. I don't do many spinner baits, but like I said, I did a batch of 10 of them last week, and they actually all ended up coming out really well. So get that swivel started. These little swivel pliers, these are great for those split rings, the little pair of split ring pliers. Great for putting these on here. So let me get these on here. That one's on good. Then we'll put the blade on, and I'll show you what it looks like. And the blade, it doesn't matter the direction of the blade on the back side of the swivel, because it's going to flap in the breeze and it'll twist on the swivel. The only bad thing about doing these like this is sometimes the split rings don't want to cooperate when you're trying to put such a big blade on there. But there we go, got it through. Okay, so this is what you got. This is what you end up with. Nice little spinner, two blades, plenty of spacing there. I don't think they're going to get hung up on each other. That's the important part, as long as they don't get hung up on each other. This one just kind of flutter. This one will spin. But these are mag willow blades. Pretty awesome. So let me see if I can get you a little side profile here. A little better side profile. There you go. So came out pretty sweet. It's a nice little spinner. I'll probably test these at some point. I don't know if I'll do any video on them, but yeah, you can see how that dangles right there. That's pretty good. Pretty good shot. So I'll put the other one together, and that'll be it for this video. This will kind of conclude. This will be like part three of the spinnerbait, making a spinnerbait from pouring lead to painting to putting it together. And one last thing we can do, and that I forgot all about, was putting some skirts on. And if you watch any of my other previous videos, this is my shad skirt that I like to make. So check out some of my other skirt making videos, and that will be on them for sure. And there you go. There is a nice shad colored with a little bit of chartreuse spinnerbait. Fantastic. Amazing. Love it. We'll do the other one real quick. So this is going to wrap this series up. There we go. So sorry about the confusion with the wire bender. That's been a touch and go kind of thing. It's been very difficult for me to do that. But bending the wires in the bottom is not so bad. Getting that form right for the top part. But when you get into that top part and you start spinning that thing, you gotta keep constant pressure down to hold the wires down, and you gotta keep twisting. My fear is I'm gonna twist that thing, especially a spinnerbait, and that hook's gonna fly around and stick right in my hand. And I've already had it do that a few times the last time I did it. So you just gotta be very careful, very cognizant of that. You can tighten down some of the nuts and stuff like that on the unit, some of the screws, to make it so it's a little bit harder, you know, so it'll stay a lot firmer. And that did help a lot. But after I did it a few times, it definitely gave me some practice, but I need some more practice. I'll be spending a lot more time on that wire bender. But anyway, thank you guys so much for watching. I got two spinners made up. Again, you can find all this stuff at Barlow's, and I will link the stuff in the description, probably the blades. I think in the other videos, I linked the mold and the wire forms and the hooks. And this one, I will do the blades, the clevises, the spacers, the beads, all that stuff. So you'll know what to get. But you should be able to find everything you need at Barlow's. Use my discount code, bait and tackle, all one word, just same thing as what's on my shirt, all one word. And it'll support the channel, and I can show you, I can buy you guys, once I start getting a few people that will contribute and buy some of this stuff, and I get some of the kickback, I will start including some of the stuff that I buy from them into some of the next coming up videos and whatnot. So we can do some more skirt materials, and we can do some more colors for jig heads, and you know, even some plastic stuff. So whatever I can find on there that might be cool, might be different for a different video, but we will definitely check out more new products going forward. So thank you guys so much for watching. Please like, comment, share, and subscribe. And always remember, keep on baiting.